Very nicely done by the Pryor High School. You can always judge a school by the sound of its band. They did a nice job.
There's a neat little story. The director over there, Kevin Speakman, went to college with Mr. Townsend, our band director at Alma. And my wife and I also were in band with Kevin. His nickname was Speak to Me.
Speak to Me. Speak to Me.
Kevin Speakman. Haven't seen him in a long time, but he seems to be doing well.
Well, the band sounded very good, waiting on the teams to get out here. So Pryor played its first game, and they took on Locust Grove. And that was way back in August, August the 25th. Then they had an open date. So they've had some time to kind of heal up some bumps and bruises if they had some.
That and to prepare for this Airedale attack. They had a good game against Locust Grove, put up 40-plus points on them, held them to less than 20. We might be a little bit tougher test for them this evening, though.
Locust Grove had a pretty tough night. It was 39-0. Locust Grove was down 39 points, and then they made it a little bit semi-respectable, 45-14. Julian Espinoza, he wears number 4, and he's their big running back, 15 carries, 119 yards in that game, a couple of touchdowns, also caught a TD pass.
Yep, right out of the backfield.
Gonna have to watch him. Jacob Couch, he's the linebacker, got to really keep an eye on. He squats 505 pounds. Give you an idea how impressive that is. They got a kid, or Alma's got a kid, Israel Towns Robinson. He squats about 365. 505 is big time.
And Israel's no slouch.
No, he's not.
But 505 is about 3 Backstreet Boys.
That's pretty good. So getting ready for this game. Got the captains on the field. Donald Mulligan, Colby Adams, and Richard Taylor for the Airedales.
And for the Tigers, number 6, Caleb Wilson. Number 7, Kendrick Probst. Number 18, Carter Raymond. Number 76, Noah Cowan. Joining them on the field, number 4, Julian Espinosa. Number 5, Jacob Couch. Number 21, Kate Edmonds. Number 59, Taylor Callison. Number 20, Ashton Cabalas. Number 66,
looks like Pryor wins the toss.
Number 24, Xander Kelso. And number 35, Jim Moscott.
They had all their senior captains mentioned on the field for Pryor. This is not senior night, although I did see a senior game earlier back in August. Harbor's first game of senior night.
That's an interesting.
Crazy. Yeah, interesting, very interesting.
Yeah, when they came onto the field, they introduced all their seniors as well. Here, Pryor. Here comes the rest of the
Airedales. Officials are from the Tulsa area. Eddie Turner is the white hat. And the Airedales are on the field. This is blackout night for the student body. The cheerleaders have on black uniforms. I know Landon told me we had blackout tonight, although I see some kids down there, and I don't see any black.
No, and not too many kids either. This is kind of a long drive for some high schoolers, and gas is not free, so might be a little light in the stands, but still cars coming into the parking lot, and I think we've got a good cheering section here.
Alma coming off a big win at home. They jumped on Solomon Springs 35-0 at halftime, had a running clock in the second half, and they won that game very, very easily, 38-14. You know, and Solomon got a couple of – give them credit. They did not quit. They got a couple late touchdowns, but that game was never in hand.
No, Solomon's been struggling for several years, and they just were no match for us offensively or defensively last week. And they were able to come back and put a few points on the board. You said, they didn't give up.
We've had 2 weeks, and at quarterback, very impressed with the play of Jackson Daly. Jackson has been a punishing runner for the Airedales on the ground. He's thrown it, completing 56% of his passes, 351 yards, but he's done a very nice job on the ground, 183 yards, 24 carries, and he scored 4 touchdowns.
Anybody that goes from tight end to playing quarterback, pretty tough.
And that's a pretty good bloodline as well.
Indeed. And he's got his younger brother guarding his blind side this year.
Yes, he is.
Easton Daly decided to play some football, and he's starting at left tackle.
Easton down there at left tackle. Easton told his dad, Adam, back in, I guess it was 7-on-7, Easton said, you know, I could probably go out there and do that. And
we've been waiting for him to come on.
Yeah. So, indeed, he did. So, the Airedales getting ready to get this thing going. The cheerleaders are on the field, and Dance team down there. We got the pep band here tonight. How was the ride over?
The ride over was good. The Alma School District does a good job of keeping those big green buses rolling.
Yes, sir.
Some of them 40 years old, but they run and the AC works, so we're all happy about that.
Well, it's a great atmosphere here in Pryor, Oklahoma. We took a detour. We went over by the high school, and let me tell you, their baseball and softball field are unbelievable. Very nice.
I think this is a fairly new complex here.
This is a very nice football stadium. This is natural grass, so this will be the one of two trips for the Airedales on grass. The other will be at Prairie Grove. Prairie Grove still has grass.
And this field we were talking about earlier looks like to be in really good shape, considering the weather that blew through this whole part of the country last night.
Yep, we had some pretty loud thunder, and of course, a strange day at the high school. The Alma High School was closed, no power, and we're hoping that's going to be rectified, and we'll be back in the building coming up on Monday. But
yeah,
a really strange day. The kids are out of school Monday for Labor Day, so they got a 3-day week. That's not bad.
That's two in a row.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's hard to have classes when there's no air conditioning, no lights.
Yeah. So Pryor's going to have the football to start this game. And they will be moving from left to right. And this football team, they've got their blue jerseys. The Airedales got the green trousers and the white jerseys.
Got Donald Mulligan kicking off.
Donald Mulligan, I saw him before the game, and I said, what grade are you in now? He goes, I'm a senior. I said, golly. Just you look up, these kids are ninth graders and sophomores, and suddenly they're a senior.
The time does fly.
It does. Mulligan's got it teed up at the 40, and this game is about to get going. Good crowd still coming in. Here comes the kickoff, and this one's going to be taken by Espinoza about the 12. He gets the 20, gets the 30. Ooh, he's cracked. Pretty tough tackle right there about the 29-yard line. So they're going to set up shop at the 29. Very good tackle by Ashton Chanavon.
Ashton Chanavon. I didn't see who was his other side on the pancake there, but they did put a pretty good lick on him.
He got popped pretty good.
You can see Espinoza's pretty shifty, too. So we're going to have to contain him in the backfield for sure.
All right, the quarterback is Braden Ward. He is in the pistol formation. Espinoza is going to go in motion. It's going to be an empty backfield on the first play of the game, and a quick pass out is going to be caught out there. That's Espinoza, and he's going to get himself a nice gain of about 10 yards. That should be a first down.
Yeah, just a quick hitter. Our slot corner was way off the ball, way off the line of scrimmage on that play. All they had to do was get it to him in open space, and he kind of did the rest.
Braden Ward is a left-hander. Their other quarterback, a really good one from a year ago, graduated, Brunt Gray. Here's a run to Espinoza. He's got some space, and he's going to rumble ahead to about the 44. So a good start for the Tigers, who pick up 10 yards on first down, 4 on second down, brings up second down and about 6.
That's just a simple handoff to the left side of the line. Had some good blocking, got to the second level. Finally stopped by the linebackers there.
Quarterback Ward waiting on his coaches. Coach is Davis. He's got a lot of time. Gets his pass across the middle. It's caught. That's another first down. Still going into Airedale territory. And that pass was caught out there by Brock Ward.
Yeah, Landon Morris had him wrapped up, and the defense came in to help him out, and they knocked Landon off, and he got a couple more yards out of that.
9 yards on the pass completion. That's brother to brother, Braden to Brock. And they're sophomores. And
there
we go. Good, nice little play by the defense on a first down carry. Not much. Noah Engel, who's come on strong his first year as an Airedale. He came in with 5 tackles.
Eric Johnson got in there and broke that up. He was the first man to make contact, and the rest of the defensive line came in and finished it off.
Eric Johnson came in with 8 tackles to start the year.
He's having a really good start to his season so far. A little bit undersized, but he's making up for it with effort.
He fits the mold of what high school football is all about. Kid with a lot of heart. Ward back the pass. A lot of time. Gets his pass across the middle. It's caught. Not a first down, but it's going to bring up a third down and very manageable Ball was caught out there by Kendrick Proff. It's going to be third down and about two. Michael Taylor on the tackle.
Two guys in the backfield.
It's going to be a run to Espinoza trying to get outside, and Espinoza is going to fight his way for a first down. And that's going to be a first down for this Pryor football team.
Cash Ferris had that end cut off, and Espinoza, being shifty, went ahead and cut inside of him, was able to pick up that first down.
First down from the Airedale 36. They're going to put a man in motion. That's Ward. That's going to be a handoff to Ward. That's brother to brother, and the Airedales are waiting for him. But not before. He's going to fight ahead for about 5 or 6 yards.
He had a good block from his end out there. Got him a couple extra yards, but the
Pryor
hole was
getting a lot
in.
They're getting a lot of penetration. These coaches wanted the football. They won the toss and wanted it. A lot of times they'll defer. Ward gets his pass away in the flat, caught out there, and that's Ward to Ward. And that should be pretty close to another first down, a little bit short.
Just another quick hitter.
Izzy in there on the tackle, came in with 6 tackles on the season. It's going to bring up third down and short again.
That brings the defense closer up to the line of scrimmage for those quick hitters.
Espinoza, the lone back in the backfield. Quarterback may be changing the play at the line. 8.5 to play. It's going to be a run to Espinoza, and Espinoza is hit hard, and he Espinoza is going to be close. Depends on the spot.
It's going to be close to the first down marker.
Izzy was in there to make the first contact. Trying to see who that was on the bottom of the pile.
They're going to give it to him. No measurement needed. They're going to give that to a first down. Eddie Turner, the official, the white hat from Tulsa. So, first down and 10 on this drive, which continues inside the Alma 30-yard line.
Yeah, Pryor's doing a good job of making their second and third downs more reasonable and manageable. They have been positive each time.
Here's a run. Espinoza almost lost it and hangs on to it. Quarterback looked like he was going to hang on to it. And Espinoza said, I'm going to keep it.
Yeah, there was almost a little bit of a miscue there on the handoff there. So that run pass option, he was trying to decide if he wanted to let Espinoza keep it or he's going to take it himself.
Let's call that a gain of 1. So second down and 9. Football is at the Alma 25. 7:40 left here in this first quarter. Clock runs. No score. Early moments of this football game. Ward back to pass, little screen pass in
there's
the flat,
a holding.
And that's going to be a hold and going to be a nice open field tackle by the Airedales. Landon Morris out there to make that stop, but let's check the marker.
That's going to be a hold.
Yep. Well, it'd be third down and about 10. What do you do here? You push them back?
Oh, yeah, you're going to push them back here. You want them. They haven't had a big explosive play. It makes you think that they can get that many yards.
So put it back at the 36 to make it second down and long.
Yeah, I think it was their left tackle that was on the hold, trying to see who he was holding. But it was plain as day. It might have been Jaden Parker that got held.
Second down and 20 from the Alma 36. Quarterback is Ward. Shotgun formation, back to pass.
Oh.
Rushes on, gets away. Gets back a little bit of yardage past the line of scrimmage, about 3, to bring up third down and long.
Gets back 3. Trey Bowen on that tackle.
Boy, Trey Bowen's another unsung hero. He's had himself a nice year.
He really has. Trey has worked really hard and just a good young man. I've had an opportunity to get to hang out with him some, and he has been all over the field this year.
He had 18 tackles before tonight.
Yeah.
That leads the team. 42 tackles as a junior. Third down and long, third down and 18 from
obvious,
the Alma 34 after a gain of 2.
Obvious passing situation here.
Ward back to pass, straight drop, good protection, gets his pass away. It's caught out near the 22-yard line.
Michael
it's
Taylor
gonna bring
on
up
the
a fourth
stop.
Down.
Now you're in. Yeah, now you're in two, well, one down territory, seven to go.
Fourth down and seven. Good job on the offensive line. Good protection all the way around.
We get a turnover on downs right here. That'll be a big boost for this defense.
Hey, we're going to go for it. It does appear. Quarterback looks over.
Yeah, three receivers to the left, one to the right. Espinosa in the backfield.
Fourth down play, quarterback back to pass. Izzy, the rush is on, gets his pass away. It's going to be incomplete.
Incomplete.
Or they're going to call it a catch. Incomplete. Yeah. Turnover on downs.
Turnover on downs.
So the Airedales stop him on fourth down and seven. That's his first incomplete pass of this ballgame.
The referee on the far side was unsure, but the one here on the near side, he was immediately calling it incomplete. He had a much better angle on it than the guy on the other side. So, that
so
was
the Airedales are going to take over, and they will be at their 23-yard line, 5 minutes and 37 seconds to play here in the first quarter.
And that's terribly deflating for Pryor. They were making such a great march, and then just a couple of mistakes.
Now you called it. They were just kind of nickel and diamond,
yeah.
and they got behind the sticks, and that was a big difference. First down for the Airedales, Jackson Daly, the quarterback at the 23. He's in there by himself, going to run it to the right side. Daly looking for a block, trying to get the edge, and Jackson Daly to about the 28, 5 yards.
That was a design run all the way. They were just spreading the field out, trying to find him a lane. Let the offensive line block those big defensive linemen and try to pull those defensive backs away from the yard line of scrimmage.
Second down and six from the 29-yard line after a gain of 6 yards. Second down and four, I should say, after a gain of six. It's going to be a run to Carlos Gonzalez. Carlos spins and fights ahead close to it. Might be about a half-yard shy. Well, he's right there.
He's really close.
They give it to him.
Yeah,
first down.
Yep.
So the Airedales extend the drive at their initial first down of this ballgame.
I'll tell you what, I really enjoy watching Carlos Gonzalez run. He puts effort into every single time he touches the ball.
Another design run, easy for me to say, and Daly, this time, is going to be stuffed about the 35.
They diagnosed that pretty easily.
They did.
Still picked up a couple yards.
So the Airedales have a second down and eight. First quarter, 4 minutes and about 30 seconds left. This is a quick first quarter. Only one penalty, a big one. It was a holding penalty that really stopped their drive.
It goes fast when there's no incomplete passes and you're running the ball. Got two wide outs.
Second down and eight for the Airedales from the 35. That's the Alma 35. Here's a run to Gonzalez.
That's Carlos.
Carlos got a little bit of a hole initially, but it's closed up in a hurry.
Quick.
Picks up about five to bring up third down and short.
Yeah, the blocking was there. He had that good hole. That linebacker just came and closed it, closed down on him. Good speed, good tackle.
Alma trying to go hurry.
Yeah,
no
Izzy
pass
in the backfield.
Attempts yet for Jackson Daly on third down and about two. Fakes the handoff. Now he's going to throw it. It's going to be dropped. Had a man out there, and it's dropped. Incomplete. Byron Standridge. And the Airedales are going to punt it.
That would have been fantastic if he'd have been able to hold on to that ball. But this is deep on our side. We're going to go ahead and punt that away. That's an easy call.
Fourth down from the 40-yard line. Standridge is going to be the punter. And it was a good ball game last week because he didn't have to punt. Anytime you don't punt, that's a good night.
That is a good night.
So Alma's first drive, the first 2 weeks they scored on their first drive, and tonight they're punting after getting one first down. There's a penalty.
Oh, it's on the defense. That's a first down.
Wow.
That is a killer.
Holy cow.
That's almost as bad as a turnover.
So the Airedales take the gift.
Yeah.
Two penalties against Pryor, and they've been big ones. First
offense
down, Alma
back on
the 45.
Field.
Alma center is Zach Millsap. The left guard is Richard Taylor. The right guard is Jaden Parker. And the tackle is Eli Waldrop. And on the left side, Easton Daly. First down from the 45. The quarterback is Jackson Daly. He's going to hand it off to Izzy. Israel Towns Robinson across midfield. Now they're going to call it midfield. Stopped at about the 50 for gain of five.
That's another good hole. Izzy hit that. And that's a nice sign of development from him because In the past, you kind of watch him slow down at the line. Now he's running through those holes, full steam. He's getting more yards.
Stoppage of play. Maybe somebody injured. Yep, I got an injured player. Looks like Parker, so they're going to take a timeout. Let's take a quick timeout with you. Nothing early on from Pryor. We'll be right back.
Accidents are never fun. Don't take your vehicle to just anyone. The professional team at Autoplex is committed to quality first and your complete satisfaction. Our ASE certified technicians will repair your vehicle to pre-accident condition efficiently and quickly with a warranty on all repairs. On-site insurance filing and rental cars available. At Autoplex, we look forward to making your experience with us easy in our state-of-the-art facility. Autoplex Collision Repair. Quality first, always.
Kevin Taylor and the great David Wright back in the building, and you and I have so much in common. It's unbelievable. We love music. We love family. We love baseball. We love Alma football.
We do. I'm not originally from Alma, but
Neither am I.
This community has taken me in, and you got me wearing green and gold all day long. And
there we go.
Enjoying it. Been good to my kids, that's for sure.
Second down and five for the Airedales from midfield. Jackson Daly, the quarterback, pistol formation, going to give it off to Izzy. Israel looking for a space, has a first down, and
there
he grinds ahead across the 40. Nice run on second down and short.
That was not a very big hole, but Izzy found it and was able to pick up the first down on that. And, again, I like watching him run through the tackles.
10 yards and a first down at the 40-yard line. Alma on this first drive. Here's a pass in the flat. That's caught. And there is Samuel Schlegel. Had a great first couple of weeks, and did he ever. You look at these numbers. I mean, they just jump off the map at you. 188 yards and 12 catches in first two games.
We just need to get him in the end zone.
Hadn't scored yet.
He hadn't scored yet, but he's done just about everything else.
Picks up 9 yards right there on first down, so second down and one from the 31. Bailey going to give it off. Nope, going to keep it and pass it. Goes out of bounds. So
a little high.
That one looking for number two, Chanabong. And it's going to be third down and one from the 31. So definitely two down territory.
Yes, sir. Yeah, talking about Samuel, he's got that gift of having an older brother that was a really good athlete. Matthew graduated last year, and I'm sure Samuel played a bunch of ball with him throughout the years.
Well, there's no kidding. Backyard football, you wanted him on your team.
Indeed.
Here is a third down quarterback run. Daly's got the first down across the 30. He only needed one. He picks up three. Move those sticks.
Just another design quarterback run.
Yeah.
That's an easy call. When you got Jackson Daly back there running like that, let him run it. He's just an extra running back at this point.
Clock runs. We are heading toward 2 minutes left here in the first quarter. Nothing ball game from Pryor, Oklahoma. Oh. And stop at your play. We got a whistle. Not sure what this is.
False start
on the offense.
I knew I saw a defender jump, but I couldn't, through these foggy windows, see we moved.
the side judge over there, no doubt, has been getting hammered from the Pryor coaches,
so
he needed something.
Yeah.
So that'll make his job easy for at least one play. 1:55 clock runs here in the first quarter. First down and 15 for the Airedales from the 34. Daly, straight drop back to pass, looking, got some space. Now he's going to pass it out there, and the pass is going to be caught.
Go.
Inside the 20-yard line, Carlos Gonzalez.
Carlos Gonzalez. He does it all out there.
First down for Alma. That's inside the 20, and they will put it down at about
23.
That's going to be the 18.
Oh, 18, sorry.
18.
I'm on the wrong side.
Needed 15, got 15.
There you go.
So first down from the 15, or the 18. After a 15-yard pass from Jackson Daly to Carlos Gonzalez. Man in motion, Daly going to run it again. Got some space. Daly up the gut.
Oh, he's
at the
gone.
Five. Walks
touchdown.
In. Touchdown, Airedales.
They gave the defense some window dressing to watch coming across the formation, and that opened up a huge hole right in the middle. Jackson Daly saw it, and he took it all the way in. What was nice on that drive, if you'll notice on that last pass that Jackson had, I think he was intending to go to the right and saw those guys were all covered. He came back to the left and found an open receiver, and that's
pretty good
That's
job.
That's a sign of maturity in a quarterback for sure.
Cade Mitchell came in 9-for-9, make it 10-for-10. And with a minute 15 to play in the first quarter, it's Alma 7 and Pryor nothing. We'll be right back.
In 1886, aluminum was developed. The first Coca-Cola was sold. The Statue of Liberty was dedicated. And Citizens Bank and Trust in Crawford County opened for business. We say, they don't make things like they used to. And maybe that's true. But for over 130 years, Citizens has served the residents of Crawford County with the best financial products and services available. And like aluminum, Coca-Cola, and the Statue of Liberty, we plan on being around for a while. Citizens Bank and Trust. That's my bank for all of Crawford County.
Back in Pryor, the Airedales drive 67 yards in 11 plays, and they jump on the scoreboard with the first points of the ballgame, 7-0. So they did score on that first drive.
They did score. A little help from the defense,
yeah.
But it's all fair when you're playing football.
And when you about to punt on 4th and 2, they got a penalty on Pryor for being offsides. The drive continued, and 7-0 Airedales. Pryor going to take this kick about the 20, a little bit shorter this time, and the run back's going to be to about the 33. It's a good return.
They made sure Espinosa didn't return that.
Yeah.
Samuel Schlegel on the tackle. He's gonna have a nice couple seasons here.
He is indeed. At Alma defense, Eric Johnson, we talked about him. He's the nose guard. And you've got Jackson Mitchell, who's having a nice year on one side, and you've got Israel Towns Robinson on the other. That's a pretty good potent duo right there.
I think he enjoys playing a little bit of that defensive end because he gets to dish out a little bit of punishment.
He does. First down for Pryor from its 33. They trail at 7-0. Here's a run to Espinosa, and Espinosa fights ahead for about 3.
Speaking of Izzy Towns Robinson, he's right there on the tackle.
Under a minute left here in the first quarter. No, that's Towns Robinson. That's okay. That's okay. Michael, number 10. Second down and 7 for Pryor from the 36. They trail at 7-0. They put a man in motion. And the quarterback fakes a handoff. Back to pass, swings it outside, and it's going to be a big loss. And a nice play by Cash Ferris. Huge effort by number 1, Cash Ferris.
Airedale saw that coming all the way, and they were all over it. I think early in this game they were playing back off the line a little bit on the receivers, and now they're coming up on them. They realize there's not a deep threat that's really just going to toast them.
15 seconds, so this should be or could be the last play here in the first quarter. Cash Ferris changed numbers. Number 1 last year, Brady Noyes, and Brady graduated, and he said, I'll take that number 1. Cash, you got 2 more years. He's only a junior.
Cash was 3 last year, wasn't he?
He was. Okay. That'll do it. So the first quarter in the books, and the Airedales have the lead. It's Alma 7, Pryor nothing. We'll be right back. Kevin Taylor and David Wright back in Pryor, Oklahoma on a gorgeous night for high school football. That's what it's all about. About 82 degrees about now?
Yeah, the sun's going down. It's going to get cooler as we go. Hopefully that'll just increase our intensity. I know I run faster when it's cooler.
Got a nice breeze. And
if I'm running.
Yeah. Now I'm up 7-0. Each team had the football technically one time. Pryor ran 2 plays. This will be their 3rd play of the second drive. 3rd down and about 12. And kind of interesting, last week this coach, Davis, took his kids. He took his team down to Fort Worth to take in the Colorado TCU game. They got a little Dion.
Yeah.
That's kind of neat.
Kind of shocked the nation there, I think, a little bit.
They did.
That would have been a fun experience to be on
if you're
been. Part of that team, that's for sure. It's like the referee is giving a little.
Waiting on the TV timeout, I guess.
Well, is that the back umpire? He was giving the offensive defensive line, a little conversation about sportsmanship is what I'm guessing.
Probably. That's Eddie Turner, the white hat, veteran referee from the Tulsa area. Third down and 13 when play resumes, and we're about to get this thing going.
Three
quarterback
wide.
Had a good first quarter. Quarterback is Braden Ward. He's a lefty. Back to pass. Rushes on. Steps up. Throws it deep. And he's going to overthrow everybody. Cash Ferris back there. He was looking for his brother Brock Ward. It's incomplete. And they're going to have to punt it.
That ball was well overthrown. That'd be back in the area of holding. I don't think we got close to hitting him. Oh.
Oh,
yes,
they're going to call late hit. I'm watching the football. So move the football to the 45. That's the second penalty on the Airedales. That's a big one.
That one hurts because we were going to get the ball back.
Yep.
Offense has got momentum.
First down and 10 from the 45 after that 15-yard mark off. It's going to be a run to Espinosa, and the Airedales have him bottled up. He gets away and runs it across midfield. They had him in the backfield. He spun away to about the 48, so a big run on first down.
I think you're going to have to get low on Espinosa. You're not going to be able to arm tackle him. He doesn't look terribly big, but apparently is strong enough to get through those arm tackles.
So Pryor, a little shot of adrenaline there after that 15-yard penalty, and they look at second down and about three at the Alma 48.
Slot receivers in motion, trying to figure out what we're running.
Quarterback back to pass, gets a little duck screen pass, got a lot of room out there. And that's going to be a first down inside the Alma 40. Jacob Couch caught it. Couch is the kid who squats 500 pounds. That's pretty impressive.
Wow. Ashton Chanavong had to take him out at the legs to get him down.
Got a flag on the play, so wipe it off. They're making second down instead of no first down, second down and going to be about eight. So the ball is back at the prior 47.
I didn't see the penalty. Looks like it must have been a spot foul. Those are the ones that hurt, too.
Yeah, 11 minutes left here in the first half. A very quick first half. It's Alma 7-0. But the Tigers trying to get the offense revved up after a big third down penalty.
That receiver at the top is lined up in the neutral zone. Yeah.
And it's going to be a timeout.
Timeout, yeah.
So a timeout taken by the head coach, Kenny Davis. Let's take it with you. We'll be right back.
Crabtree RV Center, leading the River Valley in sales and service for over 70 years. Founded in 1950, Crabtree RV Center has grown into one of the largest family-owned and operated RV dealerships in Northwest Arkansas. Located on 17 acres, including a 26,000-square-foot indoor showroom, Crabtree RV Center has everything you need, all in one convenient location. Crabtree RV Center in Alma, Arkansas, making your family's dreams come true.
Second down and about eight for Pryor after that penalty and then a timeout. So each team has burned a timeout. They have two apiece left.
That is, those are the penalties that just drive coaches crazy. You've got a first down on a great play, and then you make a penalty and bring it all back. It's just frustrating. That receiver's still lined up in the neutral zone.
Second down and eight. Quarterback gets a quick pass across the middle, nearly picked off by Cash Ferris. And going to bring up third down. Wow.
Went right through the receiver's hand. Looked like Patrick Mahomes throwing it last night right through the receiver's hands.
Cash Ferris had some green grass ahead of him, too. Trey Bowen checks out for the Airedales. Third down and eight.
I imagine Cash was ready to make the hit because
that
ball was on target.
Yeah, it was on target.
That ball was on target.
He was ready to hit him. Yeah. He'll go back Monday and watch the video and think, golly. Yeah.
It's hard to transition from a hit to interception at that speed.
Third down and eight for Pryor from their 43. They put a man in motion. That's Couch. A fumbled snap. Quarterback is down.
Oh.
And is still on the ground. They're going to call him down. It's going to bring up fourth down, I believe, from the 40.
Another miscue by the Tigers.
Yep. That's a bad snap. That's not on the quarterback.
Nope.
That's on the center.
That hit at his feet. Wasn't even close to being to the quarterback's hands. They are going to bring on the punt team.
So the Airedales looking to get their second possession. 10 minutes and 38 seconds left here in the first half. And
back deep is Samuel Schlegel. See if we can work some of his magic now.
Samuel can run.
He can. He is fast. If he gets an open lane, he's going to be gone.
Here's the punt. Going to be a nice returnable punt. Schlegel's got it from his 26. Gets a block.
Oh.
And a good tackle by Pryor. That's Jacob Couch on the stop. 9-yard return. That was going to take over from their 35. That's a good play.
That is a good play by Couch. Because if he doesn't take him down, Matt or Samuel may still be running.
Yeah.
Because who do we have out there blocking? Because he had his guy, Braden Polkett. Polkett had his man squared off.
Polkett had the first touchdown of the year and had a big catch in the game last week.
He did. He's positioning himself to have some good seasons, too.
First down for Alma from their 35-yard line. It's going to be a run. That's Carlos Gonzalez. Carlos
nice
trying
move.
To get outside at the 40, and he'll be stacked up there after about a 5-yard gain.
Carlos is typically a one cut and go guy, but he saw something there, got him a couple extra yards.
Gonzalez came into this game. He did not have a lot of carries. He had a few carries before tonight. He had 13 carries. That's his second tonight. Under 10 minutes left in the first half. It's going to be second down and 6 for the Airedales from their 39. Daly going to run it, design run. And Daly fights ahead to about the 44. Going to be third down and about 1.
And that was a design run, and the defensive line did a shift there to the left. And Jackson was able to take it to their right side. They kind of helped us out on that with their shift.
Third down and 1. Big play for the defense and a big play for the Alma offense right here. 9:20 to play in the first half. Daly going to keep it. And looks like he has it. It's going to be close. Should have it about the 41.
Wasn't a big push there, but he did get enough to get the first down. You keep the drive alive, and that's the goal.
So next Friday night, we have no football.
No football. It's a bye.
Yep.
Open date because we played in week 0.
Yep. Alma's going to be back. We've been up in Clarksville.
Clarksville on the 22nd.
Yep. That'll be the conference opener.
Salem was conference opener.
First down for the Airedales. Under 9 minutes left here in the first half. And going to be a handoff to Towns Robinson, and not much.
Yep.
He's going to get about 1 to the 41-yard line.
Yeah, that hole didn't develop like they wanted it to. He's able to get a positive yard out of it, though.
Very quick first half here from Pryor. Really impressed. Good facilities. Very hospitable. We certainly thank all the folks from Pryor to rolling out the welcome mat as we rolled into town.
Uh-oh.
Little mix-up in the backfield. Yep. Daly is going to be stopped for about a 2-yard loss.
Some miscommunication there.
Noah Cowan, senior defensive lineman.
Loss of 2 on that. This will bring up a passing down, I imagine.
So the Airedales have a third down and 11 from their 39-yard line.
Is that Drake Stogsdill on the far side? Polkett's down here on the near side.
Drake way out there. Drake only has 1 catch so far in 2 games. Daly back to pass.
Oh, Samuel was wide
Rushes
open.
Rushes on, rolls to his right, looks up, got a man down there. The ball's tipped and intercepted.
Yep. Intercepted.
Pass it to number 14, Matt Schlegel. Picked out of the air by number 60, Cantrell.
Yeah, he missed Samuel early. If he had hit Samuel earlier, he was open. But at that point, by the time he was pushed out of the pocket, threw it, there were already a few guys there.
Well, that's our first turnover tonight. We did not have a single turnover in the game last week, so that's a
no,
first turnover
by either
team.
The game against Siloam was it was pretty clean, and it went fast.
7:33 left in the first half, and the Airedales are back on defense.
Got 2 men in the backfield.
Quarterback Number one, Braden Ward, left-hander. Fakes a handoff, rushes on, steps up, going to run it. And not very far, about 1 yard, a swarm of Airedales on the tackle.
I don't know if that was a designed run or not. I think it was. But Israel Towns Robinson got in there and made him hurry up and decide in a hurry. And I'd say that's a win for the defense.
Noah Engel gets credit for the tackle. That's another stop for number 88. 7 minutes left here in the first half. Second down and nine for Pryor from the 46-yard line. They trail at 7-0. Espinoza had 15 carries, 119 yards in that first game, and he has not had many touches here tonight.
He looked like he was going to get a bunch early, and all of a sudden,
quarterback gets a little pass in the flat, and going to be a nice open
tackle
by the Airedales. Caden Minchell.
He can't just kick the ball. He doesn't just kick. He makes good open field tackles.
Boy, Caden was right there.
Well diagnosed.
You know, Caden stepped up last week and ran the ball 10 times.
He did, yeah.
He did a nice job.
We got a lot of guys out there playing last week.
Third down and 11 after a loss of 2 yards on the play. 6 minutes, 15 seconds to play here in the first half. The Alma on top 7-0. I want to thank our scoreboard sponsor tonight, Simon Dentistry.
Pryor's got three wide receivers to the near side. One to the top.
Quarterback back to pass. A lot of times slings it across the middle. It's caught. First down and more. That's his brother Ward. First down. Ball came out, but they're going to call him down at the Alma 41.
That was just a ball in motion.
Yep. They're going to go hurry. They're going in a hurry. Very quick huddle, and they're going to hand it off on a run, and not for much.
Yeah.
Gained him maybe about a half yard.
Defense was able to compose themselves and get in there and make that stop.
Airedales have done a nice job. We're going to call that no gain. So no gain on first down. Second down and 10. But Ward's got a nice little connection going with his brother.
I'm impressed with his accuracy. He, yeah, those two have probably been playing together for a really long time.
5 minutes left here in the first half. It's a second down and 10 from the Alma 41. The Airedales lead it 7-0. Man comes in motion. Ward gets a little pass, a little
That's
trick
gonna
play.
That's going to be a double pass.
Double pass and going deep. And the ball is going to be way overthrown.
Oh, no.
That's unbelievable. They're going to call a penalty. The receiver pulled the Alma kid to the ground.
Oh, wow.
That's unbelievable. The ball was, well, first off,
It's not catchable.
It's not catchable. And the receiver pulled the defender to the ground.
And they're all
That's
going for the ball.
Wow.
Where are they going? That's not a spot foul.
No.
Where are they going?
15-yard penalty is going to move it to the Alma 28. That's a tough play.
Wow.
That's a rough one right there. First down for Pryor. Takes the handoff, gets a pass, it's picked up. Airedales have it going the other way. Caden Minshew's got it.
Go, Mitchell.
Still going. He's at the 40.
Gotta get a block. Gotta get one more block. Get one more block. There it is.
Minchell's at the 15. At the 5. Touchdown, Airedales. There are no flags.
Oh, no. Polcat's gonna get a foul. That's after the score, though.
So the Airedales, with Caden Minchell running it back for a touchdown, let's check the marker. This may be a post-possession foul.
Yeah, it was after the foul. Braden Polcat was down there getting into it with somebody, and then he stepped over top of him. You can't do that.
You can't do that.
He knows better than that. He'll fix that.
Well, after the crazy pass interference play, Minchell makes a huge play on defense. Pick six.
And he got some good blocking downfield because I think number seven, who is that, was going to catch him. Kendrick Propel.
Touchdown is good.
Yeah.
Personal foul after the penalty.
Oh.
Offsetting
penalties.
There you go.
Yeah. I just saw the end, which is what referees always end up seeing. And then I saw the flag come out. I didn't see what happened to begin with. So
Caden Minchell, let's hope he caught his breath because he just ran 67 yards for a touchdown.
He's a teenager.
He is a teenager. 4 minutes and 46 seconds left to play in the first half, and Minchell trying to make it 14-0. The holder is Michael Taylor. It's a high snap, kick down, kick on the way, and the kick is
good.
Good. So the Airedales, with that turnover, each team has had one, and Alma takes advantage, and they extend the lead to 14-0. We'll be right back.
We are not a perfect church, filled with perfect people who have their life all together. We struggle with our marriages, sometimes we are judgmental, and at times hypocritical. So if you are not perfect like us, you'll fit in perfectly. First Baptist Church is a group of people who believe Jesus is the answer to what has gone wrong in our world and to what has gone wrong in our own lives. Church for us is community. Friends who belong together and people who love and serve the community of Alma are home. We would love for you to join us. We promise you'll fit in perfectly.
Kevin Taylor and David Wright back in Pryor, and we're all kind of catching our breath after that.
That was an exciting turn of events right there.
Caden Minshew with the interception and the run back.
Pryor had all the momentum after that pass interference call. And
let's be honest, Caden's not going to outrun Samuel. He's going to outrun me. Man, they can all outrun me. But,
oh, yeah.
But Caden somehow just got it to the end zone. Nice, nice return. Had a convoy of blockers back with
him. Yes.
Donald Mulligan set to kick it off at the 40. Gets his toe into it. And this is going to be taken by Espinosa at the 20. Trying to go to the right side. And Espinosa got a little space out there. Good return out to the 33.
They're doing a good job of keeping Espinosa in check. We did a good job of shedding blockers, too, to get over there and make that tackle.
Camden Curd for the Airedales making a tackle.
Camden Curd getting his football legs back under him.
Yeah,
good to see him back out there.
Camden wears number 8 when he's on the field. He's out there right now.
Yeah, he's going to play a little defense now.
Safety.
Let's see how Pryor responds to that mistake.
4:39 left in the first half. It's a first down for the Tigers from their 33. It's going to be a little
flag on the play.
Pass, shovel pass. It's going to go for about 7 or 8 yards. Not a first down. There is a flag down. There's a flag back at the 32. It's going to be a legal motion, legal set. So back them up 5
back
yards.
Back them up. Start it over. Yeah, I didn't see defense jump offside or anything, so.
So we had no penalties for a long time. Now we've had a bunch here, really, in the last about 5 minutes.
Slowing the second quarter down.
It is. 4 minutes and 26 seconds left before halftime. The Airedales off next week, and then the 22nd, they'll be
long I-40.
On the road down I-40 for conference opener against Clarksville. First down and 15. Quarterback is Braden Ward. Espinosa is the lone back. Fakes the handoff. Back to pass. He's going deep. Got the fly pattern. It's going to be overthrown. Incomplete.
He is throwing further than his receivers can go.
He's got a nice arm.
He does. And I think if he had a faster receiver, those are complete. He just needs a little more air under him. But we'll take those more shallow passes right now.
Second down and 15. And the football is at the Tiger 28-yard line. This probably is just a two-year contract, but it's been a fun couple of years.
Little home
and
home.
Pass, little home and home. Here's a pass in the flat and a good tackle from Cash Ferris. He's had a bunch of tackles tonight. That was another Ward award.
Was that Landon Morris on the missed tackle? Yeah, he almost had him. Almost had him wrapped up right as he caught the ball. Just kind of had a bad angle. That's only a gain of 5, so.
Third down and 10.
This will be another passing down. Yeah, trips to the right. Single receiver to the left.
Quarterback with Espinosa in the backfield. Straight drop back to pass. Looking for Espinosa. Got him. There's a breakdown in coverage, and he was all by himself.
And hit
out
of bounds.
Got a late flag. Let's see what the flag's going to be on. Somebody for Alma really got hammered over there. That was Landon Morris, I believe.
He's getting up.
So let's take a quick timeout with you. Now I'm up 14-0, right back after this.
Heritage Portraits has proudly provided photography services for the River Valley and surrounding areas for over 20 years, including school photography and yearbooks, youth sports leagues, corporate photography, studio sessions, and event photography. Have you been meaning to order your child's school photos? Walk-ins are welcome, and we offer on-site printing. We are located at 402 Webster Street in Van Buren. Contact us today. We're ready to photograph you.
Back to live action at a 15-yard penalty against Alma, but then we've got a motion penalty against the Tigers, so they were at the Airedale 33, put them at the 38. So Alma's had a couple of 15-yard penalties. They've had three now in this quarter, and I know Rusty Bush cannot be happy about that.
Yeah, those are really hurtful, too. I mean, you're giving momentum to a team that has not got any momentum.
Right.
And you need to stop doing that.
Keep in mind the Airedales get the second-half kickoff, so this is a huge, huge drive for the defense. First down and 15, quarterback going deep and got a man out there. It's caught. Nice pass and catch out there. Got near the 10-yard line.
He got behind the Chanenbaum, and I think Chanenbaum was expecting some safety help.
Didn't get it.
And there wasn't any there. That looked like one of those cover two situations, and the two part wasn't there.
Tigers knocking at the door, first down at the Alma 10. Here's a quick pass in the flats, incomplete. That was another dangerous throw.
Mulligan came in there and put some pressure on that, and I think that threw off the accuracy on that pass. It's amazing how just a little bit of pressure, you don't even have to make contact, just the quarterback knowing you're coming,
yep,
can make things hurry up in a split second like that.
Second down from the Alma 10.
Got three wide receivers to the left, one up top.
Ward checks with his coach on the play.
Espinoza in the backfield.
Second down play for quarterback. Ward gets a low snap, brings it in, got a man wide open. It's caught out there, and then the receiver falls down at the five. They bring up third down from the Alma 5-yard line. Looked like he fell down. There was no one around him.
Yeah, the pass might have been a little bit short, too. It's one of those you got to go down to get it. Yeah, they are definitely in two-down territory here. I don't foresee them kicking a field goal when they're this close. I could be wrong. I just want to get on the board. But we got to make a stop first.
Got to get a stop. Third down play for the Airedale defense. Been a very strange game. The offense has had the football just three times. Now we get a timeout.
Yeah.
So a timeout on the field.
Talk about it.
It's Alma 14 and Pryor nothing. We'll be right back.
And this touchdown is under review.
So, how's it look?
I'm going to go with the front and rear floor liners.
Yeah? I also went with the cargo liner. It fits perfectly.
Huh.
Wow, this is taking a long time, folks.
Hey, you see they got a bigger bump step?
Nice. So, how about the play?
Oh, he had both feet in bounds. Call stands.
The ruling on the field stands. Touchdown!
Find WeatherTech and much more at Omega Car and Truck Accessories in Alma.
Back in Pryor, Oklahoma, good crowd on hand, and a good, strong following from the Airedale faithful as well. We got the pep band here and the cheerleaders and student body, and Alma's got a two-touchdown advantage, but Pryor's got third and goal from the Alma 5.
Pryor is knocking on the door. Airedale called timeout to reset the defense. See what they drew up here.
Third down and goal. The quarterback is Braden Lord. The running back is Espinoza. They've got two receivers split out on each side. Quarterback back to pass
pressure.
In trouble. Gets away. Gets his pass away. He's got a caught. It's going to be a touchdown.
Incomplete.
Oh, he dropped
incomplete.
It. They say he dropped it. Wow.
The line judge on this side said he dropped it.
Boy, Towns Robinson came in like a man.
Yeah, just a little bit of pressure puts things in a much more hurry-up mode.
Put the football back at the five. It's fourth down and five. They got a good kicker. Let's see if they're going to kick it or go for it.
Brings up fourth and five for the Tigers.
They're going to go for it.
Bring in Jacob Couch. They're going to keep the offense on the field.
Think they'll run to his side?
2 minutes and a second left here before halftime.
Couch makes the left side the strong side.
Now they're going to get a timeout. So Timeout taken by the home team. Let's take a quick break with you. It's Alma 14, Prior nothing. Back after this.
Hey, I'm Brent.
I'm Dale. But you have to call me Dragon.
Well, then you have to call me Nightwing.
All right, Nightwing. Let's play a little game. On the count of three, I want you to say your favorite travel center. Don't even think about it. Just say it, all right? One, two, three.
Workman! What's your favorite deli item? Chicken strips!
Do we become best friends?
Yeah!
All right!
Let's go to Workman's!
Workman's?
Yeah!
Well, we're not quite halftime, but 2 minutes and a second left before halftime. The Airedales have a 14-0 lead in a ball game that's kind of gone back and forth. Jackson Daly had an 18-yard touchdown run, and Caden Minchell had a long interception return for a touchdown, and Alma offense has only had three series. Very, very odd game.
Yeah, defense has been on the field a lot, but they've been doing their job. They've been keeping them out of the end zone, but they're going to go for it here on fourth down.
Espinosa, the running back.
Strong side is the left side.
Braden Ward, the quarterback, on fourth down and goal, puts a man in motion, rolls out, going to go back the other way. Got a man down there. It's going to be intercepted.
Broken up. That's turnover.
Great coverage out there by the Airedales. Ashton Chenevon breaks it up. So he was going to go to his left and then turned around and went back looking for the
Everybody went to
receiver.
The left. That receiver went back to the right, and Ashton maintained his discipline and was able to cover that receiver. And the ball stayed up in the air so long, he was able to get into a position to almost pick it off. Of course, if he had picked it off, we'd have lost 4 yards.
Chenevon and the defense do their job again. So a minute 55 before halftime, the offense back on the field, Jackson Daly, and the Airedales have it from the five. So not a lot of time in each team. Well, Alma's got two timeouts left.
Pryor's just got the one timeout left, so I think they may just want to get to the locker room and try to figure some things out.
First down from the five, and it's going to be a run, and not much. In fact, Gonzalez is going to lose a yard back to the four.
Number 24, the ball carrier. That's Carlos Gonzalez.
Yeah, he lost one on that play.
He did. Second down and 11. You want to be careful.
Don't want to get careless down here.
Second down, Airedales.
This is a protect the ball and get to the locker room situation.
Second down and 11 from the 4 yard line. Daly in the pistol formation, back to pass.
Oh, he's wide
steps
open.
Up, steps up, going to run it. Now he's going to throw it. Got a man down there. It's going to be caught by Samuel Schlegel. What a catch! Schlegel caught it at the 47 yard line. First down, Alma.
Now we've gone from run the clock out, get to the locker room to let's run the field and score some more points.
43 yards on the connection. He had one last week for 49, so it's a first down, Alma.
You know, this is a young season. I've seen Samuel Schlegel do that a number of times.
He is a playmaker.
Daly's got a lot of confidence in him just to throw it up there and let him come down with it. That was a great play.
Minute 15 left before halftime. Daly back to pass, rushes on, steps up, throws
wide open.
Got a man out there. It's caught.
Stogsdale?
Stogsdale's got it at the 40. Cuts it back to the 37-yard line. First down, Alma.
You know, last year, Drake Stogsdale had a great season. He and Joe Trusty had a great combination going on. Looks like he and Daly are starting to develop a little bit more chemistry now.
That's his second catch. He had one catch last week, none in week one. A minute left here before halftime. It's Alma 14-0 and driving for more. Daly's going to hand it off to Towns. Robinson got a big hole.
Good hole.
Izzy to the 31. Clock runs with 45 seconds.
They had a linebacker trying to come in on a run blitz there, and Izzy went the other hole.
We're going to put it down at the 32, so that's going to be a nice gain on first down. Second down play, and Daly going to hand it off again. Yep. Towns Robinson's got some space outside. Gets to the 24-yard line. And the Airedales call timeout with 29 seconds left here in the first half.
I'm going to be honest with you. Izzy looked like he was about to jump those guys.
He did.
He looked like he was going to try to jump, and he thought better of it because there were two of them.
I want to thank our scoreboard sponsor tonight, Simon Dentistry. And I'm pretty sure they're connected with pretty much everybody in Alma. Simon Dentistry.
Yes.
I know they are the Kevin and Marty Taylor family.
Yeah. Well, 100%. Jeremy is a one of the coaches on the Alma Youth Trap Club that I was part of
right.
for the last 6 years or so, and he's one of the coaches. Both of his boys are on there, or two of his boys are on there. Good shooters, good shooters.
Absolutely. So the Airedales up 14-0 after a big stand by the defense. Boy, Pryor's got to be just shaking their head. They had 45 points week one, had a big lead against Locust Grove, and tonight they have just, well, each team's had a lot of mistakes, but Pryor's had more.
Yeah. Theirs have been more costly.
Football is at the Tiger 24-yard line with 29 seconds left.
Got an empty backfield.
Daly, the quarterback, in the pistol formation. They put a man in motion. They handle that little trickery there. Oh. Daly, back to pass, going the wheel route outside. It's incomplete.
That went off the back of the defender's head.
It did.
Hit him in the helmet. Otherwise, Drake is there.
Yeah, the wheel route.
Yeah.
Boy, a lot of trickery right there.
There was a lot of ball movement on that.
Chris Smith's been hanging onto that one for a long time.
I'll tell you what, I'm going to give a lot of credit to the offensive line on that one, because when the ball is getting handed off that many times and your guy still has the time to throw it and set his feet, that is a good job by the offensive line.
Second down and 10 from the Pryor 24. 20 seconds on the clock. Daly rolls to his left, steps up. Now he's going to tuck it and run it. Daly trying to get to the sideline, gets there. Daly to the 20.
He looked like he was about to go down, and he saw a hole and took it, and wisely got out of bounds and preserved the timeout.
12 seconds on the clock. I'm not sure. I think Alma may be out of timeouts.
They got one left, don't they?
It shows one, but there was an injury. I thought they took a timeout on the injury. Maybe not. 12 seconds on the clock. Alma's got it at the 20-yard line. They want to obviously get a little bit closer for Caden Minshew if they can.
A 37-yard field goal from here.
Daly back to pass, steps up, looks to his right, got a lot of space out there, got to run it, got to hurry, got a man down there, throws it for up in the air. It's going to be intercepted. Ward's going to pick it off in the back of the end zone. So a little pressure coming from the Tigers. And Brock Ward picks it off. And the Tigers, with no time on the clock, that's going to be halftime.
I don't think that's what the coaches wanted out of Jackson.
No,
they might have preferred him to go ahead and throw that incomplete. Just give yourself a chance for that 37-yard field goal. Play a little more points on the play, on the board.
Halftime here from Pryor, and mistake-filled first half by both teams, but the Airedales have the better hand, and they've got the lead at halftime, 14-0. Let's take timeout.
All right, now that we're finally here, what's your favorite homemade jelly or jam? Peach jam! Me too!
Yeah.
Wow. Look at all the amazing honeys and jams, and all these other goodies. Wow.
Excuse me, ma'am, that looks delicious. Oh, burger, not bad burger. They're really good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was amazing. Look at the wide variety of gifts. Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Workmans! Yeah!
Omega Car and Truck Accessories would like to invite you to come by and take a tour of our new retail showroom behind Brahms in Alma. Interactive working displays and a fully stocked warehouse allow you to pick out today's hottest accessories and get them installed fast. Wheels and tires, audio video, LED lighting, steps, lift kits, bed liners, custom interiors, towing, computer cut window tinting, Omega does it all. And with certified technicians, we guarantee the job will be done right. If customer service and value are important to you, choose Omega Car and Truck Accessories.
Spartan General Contractors is a construction company equipped with highly trained and experienced individuals ready to support you with your next construction project. Residential or commercial, Spartan has the resources needed to help you achieve your final goal. One of our main objectives at Spartan is to keep your project on time and within your budget. While the thoughts of your next construction job can seem complex and overwhelming, let Spartan General Contractors help alleviate that stress and make your next project become reality.
Here at the University of Arkansas Fort Smith, we do things differently.
Because here, learning doesn't just happen on screens and in books. We learn through action.
With degree plans that are on our terms, whether in class or online.
And because UAEFS is the most affordable four-year campus in Arkansas,
we can do it all without going into debt.
So when we graduate, we don't just have a diploma. We have a resume that will launch our careers.
Act Accidents are never fun. Don't take your vehicle to just anyone. The professional team at Autoplex is committed to quality first and your complete satisfaction. Our ASE certified technicians will repair your vehicle to pre-accident condition efficiently and quickly with a warranty on all repairs, on-site insurance filing, and rental cars available. At Autoplex, we look forward to making your experience with us easy in our state-of-the-art facility. Autoplex Collision Repair. Quality first, always.
In 1886, aluminum was developed. The first Coca-Cola was sold. The Statue of Liberty was dedicated. And Citizens Bank and Trust in Crawford County opened for business. We say, they don't make things like they used to. And maybe that's true. But for over 130 years, Citizens has served the residents of Crawford County with the best financial products and services available. And like aluminum, Coca-Cola, and the Statue of Liberty, we plan on being around for a while. Citizens Bank and Trust. That's my bank for all of Crawford County.
Crabtree RV Center, leading the River Valley in sales and service for over 70 years. Founded in 1950, Crabtree RV Center has grown into one of the largest family-owned and operated RV dealerships in Northwest Arkansas. Located on 17 acres, including a 26,000 square foot indoor showroom, Crabtree RV Center has everything you need, all in one convenient location. Crabtree RV Center in Alma, Arkansas, making your family's dreams come true.
Well, it's halftime here at Pryor, and really kind of a strange first, a really quick first half, and then second quarter kind of slowed down some. Alma's got 10 first downs, Pryor's got 11, but the big number on the scoreboard, Alma's got 14.
That is a big number indeed, because Pryor was moving the ball up and down the field until it mattered, and then the defense shut him down.
So Alma's really done a nice job on defense stopping the run. Pryor, 12 attempts on the ground, just 16 carries, and my math tells me that's about 1.3 per carry.
That is a good average for our defense.
They have completed 12 passes. The quarterback, Braden Ward, is 12 for 20 for 110 yards, but that's only 5.5 yards a reception.
And a lot of his passes that have been completed have been short. They've made a lot of their big gains on penalties.
Alma's done a nice job. Alma's got two turnovers. Alma's 2 out of 5 on third down conversions. Pryor, surprisingly, is 5 out of 8. But fourth down conversions, Pryor's 0 for 2.
Yeah.
That's a big stat. Alma's 0 for 0.
Those should just be turnovers in the turnover column.
Alma's had 26 combined plays for 161 yards, and for Pryor, 32 for 126. The defense has really done a nice job here tonight, and we'll get some individual stats here daily. Passing is 4 out of 9 for 83 yards, 2 picks. And really, both of those, he kind of forced it in there.
The last one was a Hail Mary.
Yes, yeah, pretty much.
He was on the run trying to make a play at the end. The other one was tipped ball.
Yep.
But he was under pressure there, too.
Samuel Schlegel, 2 catches, 52 yards. And Drake Stoggs, the 1 for 16. And Carlos Gonzalez, 1 for 15. And then on the ground, Daly's got 37 yards, 8 carries. Towns Robinson, 5 carries for 29 yards. And Carlos Gonzalez, 4 carries. For 12 yards. And really, that last play, we're just running out of time.
Yep.
And just, you know, he could have run it. It's easy to quarterback from the press box.
It is.
Man, if he just run it, you never know. Well, you know, that's a kid down there. It's a high school kid.
It is. And, you know, it's his first year starting at the position as well. I mean, so you can't fault him for trying to put that effort into it. He probably thought he had a little more time and could at least get one more play out. But, yeah, probably throwing that one in the dirt somewhere. Would have been a better play, and he'll see that film study, and they'll coach him up.
Really, the big stat in the first half, the penalties. Alma had some big 15-yard penalties that kept drives alive, but the defense stepped up. They had a first down and goal from the 10,
indeed,
and had 4 cracks at it, and only got 5 yards out of 4 points.
Yeah. Yep.
Alma had a nice stop on 4th and 5.
Yeah, down at the goal line. Some of that it was self-inflicted on Pryor as well. They're not immune to the errors as well. And those are really hurting them right now. 7 of those points are a big, big penalty for what they did.
Well, it's not. We're not late in the year. It's early. And these teams, yeah, you had a scrimmage game, and that's going to help you a little bit. But still, this is not week 7 or 8.
No.
So teams are going to make mistakes. And both teams have made some. And big play for the Airedales here tonight. So far, I would say to Caden Minshew, run back on the interception.
That is play of the game so far, indeed.
Caden Minshew got it and had a big convoy of blockers and just kind of rumbled. He kept stumbling. I could hear Chris Berman in my ear going, rumbling, stumbling.
Yep.
All the way down for the end to the end zone.
And then he lined up and kicked the extra point.
And then, well, luckily, and well, not luckily, there were some offsetting penalties after the play, but he had a couple minutes to catch his breath there.
Yes.
But the Airedales have a 14-0 lead. So your coach, Rusty Bush, and he's got a really good staff, what did they talk about at halftime?
Well, defense, mistakes. Stop hitting out of bounds. Stop doing pass interference. Of course, one of those was pretty questionable. Let's have good sportsmanship. Let's not walk over people we've knocked down. That's okay if you knock them down, but let's not walk over the top of them. Offensively, keep doing what you're doing. You haven't got the ball much.
Right.
Three possessions, two scores. That's a win in the offense book. So I think they keep doing what they're doing offensively. They may try to open up the passing game a little bit more because clearly we're having success with that here, especially towards the end of the second quarter.
Yeah, a huge, nice play. A big 43-yard pass completion to Samuel Schlegel. Got him down close.
Yep.
And we're at halftime. Alma is on top of Pryor 14-0. The Airedales are off next week. No football. So take your family out to dinner and stay home. Maybe go watch another game. That'd be kind of fun.
Yeah.
And then the Airedales will open up 5A West play on the 22nd at Clarksville. It's crazy to think, but Alma's next home game is not until the 29th. That's nuts.
Host of the Farmington Cardinals, which will be a tough test. Farmington in the last couple of years has really got developed into a really good football program.
Well, did you guys okay in the storm?
Yeah, I got woken up. I have a CPAP machine, and when the power goes out, I quit breathing.
Uh-oh.
So I tend to wake up pretty easily on that deal.
Man, well, it was pretty loud thunder about 4 o'clock in the morning.
And it didn't seem to stop.
No, my trees are okay. My cat still got to eat at 5 o'clock. It's all good. So.
I think the downtown area took the brunt of it.
Yeah.
Obviously, the high school was closed for the day because they didn't have power. The Boys and Girls Club was shut down. I heard Walmart was down for a while.
Yeah.
So, you know, when Walmart goes down, it's serious.
Well, I circled by there, and they had cones out trying to block people from going in.
Yeah.
And it looked like there were people still trying to get in.
Sure.
Why are y'all shut down? You know, anyway. So.
Yeah.
Well, it's halftime. We want to thank Matt Farrell. It's a crazy day. Matt drove over here because no power back in the school, so we have to do everything on site. And, of course, thanks to the Airwaves Media for getting everything going. And halftime, it's Alma 14 and Pryor nothing. Let's take about a 5-minute timeout. We'll be back after this.
Heritage Portraits has proudly provided photography services for the River Valley and surrounding areas for over 20 years, including school photography and yearbooks, youth sports leagues, corporate photography, studio sessions, and event photography. Have you been meaning to order your child's school photos? Walk-ins are welcome, and we offer on-site printing. We are located at 402 Webster Street in Van Buren. Contact us today. We're ready to photograph you.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for the Pride of Pryor. All right, all you Tiger fans, get off your seats and on your feet. The band plays our school fight song.
Halftime at Pryor, the Airedales up 14-0. Kevin Taylor and David Wright, and 14-0 seems to be the score of the moment. Southside on top of Wynn at halftime 14-0, and our buddies at Ozark Club, they lead Charleston 14-0.
Oh.
So 14-14 is all across the board.
Battle of Franklin County.
Yeah, the old Battle of Franklin County. Yeah. So the Airedales up at halftime, they will have the second half kickoff. And a really nice job by the Pryor band. I know those kids, they work all week like everybody else.
Oh, yeah.
And they're out there. I tell you, the Alma band, they get out
like
there in the morning.
Every morning.
And, RCD boy, it's been hot RCI and humid.
I don't know that people realize how much the band kids work. I mean,
they do.
They come out a week or two before school even starts. And all summer long they're doing, you know, conditioning type stuff. And, you know, then they get out there when school starts. It's every morning. And on Monday nights, they're out there practicing as well. And so it just develops a lot of character and discipline. And those are some of the best kids in your school.
Yep.
And they just need to be around.
I've got drop-off duty in the morning, Wednesday and Thursday, and I enjoy that. And I look out there, and the band kids are out there. And when they get going, when they all get out there, and they're doing calisthenics.
Yeah, yep.
And they get the music going. Yep. Yesterday we had the Fit ABBA. So that was nice.
Yeah.
A little ABBA going.
Yeah, Mr. Townsend has them do some stretching and stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
And, you know, injuries are a part of marching band, too. You wouldn't think it as much.
Right.
And you probably wouldn't notice it as much. But, hey, you'll pull a hamstring or twist a knee or something, and you get out there and get loose, just like any other athlete. You know, it's better for your body. You know?
Alma's got a really strong arts, the choir. They do a great job. Miss Overton does a fantastic job. And for years, the Whitworths did a great job. And very strong choir, very strong band.
Yeah, the Silent Springs game, the chamber choir and the freshman choir, the honors choir
very
were
neat.
Out there. And they did a great job with the national anthem.
They did.
So that's a pretty neat deal.
We've
got some really talented kids for sure.
We do. And, you know, what I liked about that, the choir, the national anthem, you look down there and you saw sprinkles of athletes.
Yes.
I saw Gavin Kurt down there.
Yep.
I saw Ferris, Cash right. Ferris down there.
There were probably 10 to 15 band members that
left
their positions and hopped into that as well. And if you were at the exhibition volleyball game, the Razorbacks, Jacob DeSanto sung the national anthem, and it was fantastic.
It was.
When you're up there by yourself and you're doing that a cappella,
you bet.
And he nailed it. It was really, really good stuff.
That's on the bucket list, but I don't think anybody's interested in my bucket list. So why is that? Well, basically, I can't sing.
Well,
here you go.
Put a little practice in. They just might give you the microphone.
I would have to lip sing. I'd have to have somebody else sing it and act like I was kind of helping out.
Yeah.
I know the words. I've been to a million games.
Indeed.
Anyway, halftime, and the Airedales up 14-0 here from Pryor, waiting on the second half. We're going to get the football to start the second half, and coaches and the players back on the field.
Still waiting on Pryor to get out of the locker room, I think.
Kind of interesting, Pryor, they got a super high school, and the field, the football field, is completely across town. And so they go to their high school to get dressed. They bus them over. They didn't show up over here until about 6:15.
I don't know what I think about that. I feel like it kind of you lose some steam, you know.
It's interesting.
When you're on your own campus,
you
get kind of, you know, pumped up for your games and stuff like that. And I think busing over, like Van Buren has to do.
Right.
You know, their high school is not with
same
their
thing.
Campus. Yeah.
Yep. So. Officials are starting the clock. They're ready to go. They want these guys got a long drive back home. Pryor finally back on the field. So now the clock is set for a two-minute warm-up.
Yeah.
2.5 minutes right now. So the Airedales on top 14-0. Once again, no football next week. Alma's going to be off. That's the open date. Played 0 week. And then the Airedales open up conference play on the 22nd against Clarksville.
Now not 45 minutes away.
So the Airedales getting their wind sprints in. Kevin Taylor and David Wright tonight with you from Pryor. And the wind's still kind of breezy out there. It's picked up a little bit.
I'm trying to figure out, is that the northeast?
I think that's northeast where you're pointing toward.
That's where the breeze
flag
is coming from.
Right, right.
Yeah. It's been blowing on me. I've enjoyed it.
I can tell you this morning at 5 o'clock, the breeze was straight out of the north.
Out of the north, yes.
I'm not a weatherman, but I think when that hot humidity and that cold air, they don't like each other.
I had a student at the primary school ask me this morning, why was it raining? I said, because the cold air hit the hot air.
It did. Officials meeting at midfield. Officials from the Tulsa area. Eddie Turner is the white hat. And the Airedales, again, the next home game is going to be on September 29th, as they will be home to take on the Cardinals out of Farmington. That'll be
and
a big one right there.
We'll be hoping for much cooler weather at home.
Oh, yeah.
I get spoiled up there in the press box because we've got a 3-ton air conditioner unit for about 60 square feet.
Yeah.
And it gets a little chilly up there. So I know the fourth floor was pretty warm last week.
So David Woolley walking around up here in the press box during that first half.
He tends to make his way around all the time.
He's around everywhere.
They used to. He would go with them on the some of the dance competitions, like to Orlando and stuff. And he would just disappear. So the dance team would start a game of where's Woolley, trying to find, you know, like where's Waldo. But he's a big supporter of not pretty much everything that these students do.
And lifer. 50 years as superintendent.
Indeed. And he's got that marching band roots in him as well. And you know, the arts were really important to him, and they named the theater for him there at the Performing Arts Center. And so that was a pretty neat recognition for him there. Kids came into town for that. Got to see Jared.
Alma's had strong administration for many, many years, another strong superintendent, Dr. Duffy.
Yep.
And, of course, the principals in the buildings, Brian Kirkendall, and this year got Manessa Moore.
Yeah.
Stepped up from being a counselor and first-year principal, along with Dr. Jason Reeves.
We do have good leaders at the high school.
We do.
Been blessed.
It's been quiet. Been a good start.
Yeah,
been
we like quiet.
Yeah, knock on wood. Yeah. Until today.
Yeah.
And what was that old commercial back in the 70s? It's not nice to mess with Mother Nature.
That's right. I think they're just happy, you know, that the arena didn't flood again. So.
Well, Pryor's got it teed up at the 40, and the Airedales ready to take this thing back. Drake Stocksdale, one of the back players back deep, along with Samuel Schlegel. It is a gorgeous, clear night. Boy, it's really cooled off. It feels great out there.
It does feel good. You got Caden Minchell, Israel Towns Robinson, and Trey Bowen in the short areas.
Going to be a sky kick. Going to be a short kick.
Izzy's going to get it.
Israel Towns Robinson's got a little space up near the 44-yard line. And the Airedales are going to take over probably about the 43.
I don't know how well they were communicating with each other, but both of them thought they were about to get that ball. And I think Izzy just beat him by half a step.
Well, that's a dangerous play, too.
It is, yeah.
That sky kick. A lot of teams
try to beat
some
you to
teams
it.
Will do the fair catch on that.
Yep.
So the Airedales take over in really good shape at almost midfield at the 43. They lead it 14-0. Opening moments here of the second half, first down and 10 from the 43.
Got two.
Running back is going to be Carlos Gonzalez. Quarterback's going to hand it. Nope, going to keep it. Going to be a run, design run. Yep. Jackson Daly to the 49.
Another good game.
Daly to about the 48. So that's a gain of about 6 yards. And the Airedales have a second down. They're going to put that closer to the 49, so that's a good spot.
Yep.
6 yards on the run on first down.
Yeah, they announced four like runs. That. But, he definitely had more than four on that carry.
Daly back to pass. Schlegel. Swing pass outside. Schlegel gets a block, has a first down, and missing his block. Helping out for a moment was Polkat.
He tied him up long enough to get the first down.
He did.
There was another defender on the hunt anyway, so he wasn't going to get much further.
Airedales have a first down from the prior 44. Big, big series.
Get stuck.
Start the second half.
On the near sideline.
Quarterback's going to hand it off. That's Carlos Gonzalez with his fifth carry tonight to the 40. Carlos had four carries, 12 yards in the first half. So he's got five carries on the night and 16 yards. Second down and about six for the Airedales.
And the offense keeps winning first downs.
Yep, that's a big one. Really, they only had one series where they had a misplay on a first down and backed them up.
Yep, first and 15 on that one penalty.
Second down and six from the prior 40. They put Drake Stocksdale in motion. Jackson Daly back to pass in trouble. Gets out of it, going to run it. 40 to the 35. Is close to a first down. I think he's about a yard shy. Let's check the spot.
That was a nice scramble to get out of there because he had guys breathing down his neck. In fact, I thought they had him. I don't know how he squirted out of there, but he did.
Needed the 40, needed the 34, third down and one. Third down and one for the Airedales. See if Daly's going to keep it here. Yeah. It's going to be a design run. Jackson Daly's got a first down and more. Inside the 35 to the 33. Needed about one, got about three.
Yep, that's another design run for Daly, and Izzy was back there for the lead block, and he just followed him through the hole and scooted around the edge and picked up the first down, and we're moving on to the next set of downs.
First down from the prior 33-yard line. Alma leads at 14-0. Want to thank our scoreboard sponsor tonight, Simon Dentistry. It's going to be a run. Towns Robinson cuts
nice back. Nice cutback.
And Izzy stumbles. Still on his feet. Still going. To the 15. To the 10. Outside to the 5-yard line. Inside the 5.
That's Israel Towns Robinson we've been waiting on.
Tough run from Israel Towns Robinson. And boy, the Airedales have a first down and goal.
That's some good vision because he was designed to go to the left. There was nothing there. He came back to the right. One guy to beat. Ran him over. Had to chase him down to stop him. Now you just need three more yards.
30 yards on the run. That's his second longest run of the year. That 64-yard touchdown run at Van Buren in week one. First down and goal for Alma from the 3. Jackson Daly, the quarterback, going to hand it off to Towns Robinson. Izzy to about the 1.
Oh, they called him down right at the goal line.
Justin Pryor. Airedales won last year 36-27, and tonight trying to go up 21-0. Second down and goal from the 1. Daly going to hand it off to Towns Robinson. He is hit in the backfield and nothing.
Nope.
No gain.
No gain.
So now, Airedales,
do you try to pound it one more time?
Yep.
Or do you try to run something different? Going to pull Izzy out. Trey Bowen goes in.
Football is at the 1. Third down and goal from the 1-yard line. Pryor fans, student body on their feet.
Strong to the left side.
Daly is going to keep it himself. Jackson Daly going to be down at the 1. No gain. Oh. So fourth down for the Airedales.
Boy, there was a shoestring tackle right there before he got really going. And he saved him 6 points there.
Right at 8 minutes left here in this third quarter. Do you kick it? You got a good one.
They're going to put their foot on their throat.
Yep. Daly on fourth and goal from the prior 1. Going to keep it. Jackson Daly is hit and spins.
Touchdown.
He's in. Touchdown.
Went over there behind his brother.
That's a good one to run behind. Easton Daly with a good block, and the Airedales get the touchdown on fourth down and 1. And for Jackson Daly, that's his fifth rushing touchdown in the first 3 games.
That's just a nice methodical drive down the field, nothing fancy. Line up, hit the man in front of you.
57-yard drive. There's flags down. The kick is good, but let's check the marker. This may be offsides, and we'll decline it. Both teams are headed to their sidelines. So Alma goes 57 yards and 8 plays, and they extend the lead to 21-0. Let's take timeout.
Hey, I'm Brent.
I'm Dale, but you have to call me Dragon.
Well, then you have to call me Nightwing.
All right, Nightwing. Let's play a little game. On the count of three, I want you to say your favorite travel center. Don't even think about it. Just say it, all right? One, two, three.
Workman! What's your favorite deli item? Chicken strips!
Do we just become best friends?
Yeah.
All right.
Let's go to Workman's.
Workman's.
Yeah!
We are back. Donald Mulligan's got it teed up at the 40. Alma's up 21-0 after a methodical drive and a nice kick. This one's going to sail.
Whoa.
And that one's going to roll out of bounds. Good kick, but they shot away from it. And the ball trickles out of bounds. So the Tigers will take over.
Yeah, that ball had just enough momentum to get out of bounds. He kicks that a few yards shorter. That gets real interesting real fast.
It's kind of like my golf wedge. It's not going to stop. It's going to keep going the other way. So first down and 10 at the 35. Coach Tom McMurray, we always kind of joke back and forth. It's funny on the penalties out of bounds on kickoff. Some officials put it at the 35, some at the 40.
Yeah.
That cracks me up. First down, 35.
We're in Oklahoma now.
Braden Ward, the quarterback, going to put a man in motion. That's his brother, and he's going to give it to his brother, and his brother trying to get outside and got a little space out there and going to be tackled after about a three-yard gain.
Yeah, he ran about 30 yards there and picked up two.
So you do the public address announcing. Do you watch the other guys when you're on the road, the other announcers?
You know, I will listen to them and see if there's something I like and don't like, and I'll steal from them if they got something that's cool.
That's it. Low snap, ball's deflected, incomplete. Somebody got a hit, got their hand out. I think that was Noah Engel.
And I'll listen to our fans, too. They'll be like, did you hear that announcer? That was awful, right? Did you hear that announcer? That was great.
Longtime sports writer here. And so when I'm covering the game, you're keeping stats, you got to watch the PA announcer. You can tell early if he's going to be on. A lot of times they're not on. Ball's going to be not at the right spot.
Yeah.
Third down and 8. Ward back to pass, has some time. Now the rush is on, gets his pass away.
Nice.
It's going to be caught, but not for much. Espinosa's going to lose a yard.
Landon Morris on the tackle. He read that all the way. He was spying him the whole time.
So fourth down, the Tiger punting team is on the field.
Well, I'm not going to lie. When I'm up there in the press box on Friday nights, I've got a lot of help.
You do.
I've got somebody spotting for me for the defenders. I can typically keep up with the offensive players, but – you know, the guys running the game clock will keep me up to date on the downs and yardage and that kind of stuff. So,
defensive coordinator Zach Jones gets a 3-and-out. Got to love that.
Indeed. Back deep is Samuel Schlegel.
They're going to punt it. Fourth down and 8, fourth down and 9. Here's a low kick. Schlegel is going to get it
drive
from his 37-yard line. Good tackle. Schlegel picks up about 5 yards on the return to the 44.
That's a good open field tackle.
That is.
Because when you're putting it like that, you better have somebody that can cover and tackle.
29-yard punt and a return of about 5 yards. First down, Alma from the 44. They're up 21-0. There is no mercy rule, so you could win it by whatever, but you still want to keep the offense clicking and going.
Indeed.
No mercy rule in Oklahoma. First down, Alma, from the 44.
Come back out here and resume what you did on the first drive of the half.
That's it. Daly is going to hand it off. That's Carlos Gonzalez trying to bounce it outside.
Oh, there he goes.
Gets outside. 50 to the 45. Gets a block inside the 40.
Nice run. That's vision. That's just good vision. You can't coach that. That's just there.
Boy, Easton Daly on that left side. He's a
plowing.
Wall.
He was plowing. That's good stuff.
18 yards on the run from Carlos Gonzalez, and that doubles his pleasure. He had 5 carries for 16 before that, so 34 yards on the night. on six carries for number 24.
And the defense helped us out on that one, too, because the whole line shifted to the left. They keep helping us out on positioning.
Daly back to pass, looking to go deep across the middle. Got a man down there. It's incomplete. Looking for Carlos Gonzalez, second down and 10.
You know, Carlos was open, but he was about to not be open, and I think Daly saved him from absolutely getting crushed.
He did.
I think the quarterback saw the defenders there and put it only where Carlos could catch it, and it just wasn't up high enough for him to grab. But a good effort.
Daly threw for 83 yards in the first half. 4 for 10 on the night. Second down and 10 from the 38. It's going to be a run. Gonzalez.
Oh.
Good tackle after a gain of about 5 yards. It looked like it was going to be a big play.
Yeah. He got pulled down funny. That's a good stop by the right tackle.
It's going to be a gain only of about 4 yards, so third down and 6 from the 34. Gonzalez checks out. 40 yards on the night for Carlos.
Samuel Schlegel and Drake Stogsdale down here to the near side. I saw Polkett and...
Daly fakes the handoff. He looks going to the left side. Got a man out there. It's
caught.
Stogsdale at the 25-yard line. There are no flags. First down, Alma.
And that's what you want to do. Just bob and weave, bob and weave. Keep picking up yards. Win that first down every time. Second and third downs get easy. And at some point, the defense is going to get tired.
First down and 10 from the 25-yard line. Man in the backfield is Towns Robinson. He's going to fake a handoff, throws it out to Samuel Schlegel. Schlegel to about the 19. 6 yards on the reception. Not much, just kind of nickel and dime. But another good play on first down.
Another good play. The defense was fooled on that because they saw Izzy in the backfield. And a lot of them fell for that play fake. And 6 yards is nothing to sneeze about on first down. That's another win on first down.
Going to bring up a second down for the Airedales, second down and 4. 4 minutes and 15 seconds left here in the third quarter. Daly takes a handoff, gets his pass across the middle.
There it is.
Touchdown, Alma. Samuel Schlegel. Well, he's on the board.
He's on the board. He finally got
his first one.
And again, that's a receiver on the move, and Daly hit him in stride. He did not have to slow down to come back and get the ball. He didn't have to reach out, and he beat his man.
19 yards on that catch and run. Beautiful throw, good protection, and a win for the Airedales. They lead it 27-0. So good two drives for the Airedales. The PAT kick's good. Caden Minshew is perfect on the year. He's 4-for-4 tonight, 13-for-13, and it's Alma 28. Pryor, nothing. Let's take time out.
Now that we're finally here, what's your favorite homemade jelly or jam? Peach jam! Me too!
Yeah.
Wow. Look at all the amazing honeys and jams, and all these other goodies.
Wow. Excuse me, ma'am, that looks delicious.
Oh, burger, that's my burger.
They're really good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was amazing. Look at the wide variety of gifts.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Workmans! Yeah!
Well, the Airedales have had two drives, very, very easy drives. They go 57 yards and 56 yards back-to-back drives, and they get it in the end zone. Daly with a 1 yard run and a 19-yard strike to Samuel Schlegel.
Yeah, the defense isn't putting up much resistance right now. I think they're starting to wear down, and now they're starting to look at a scoreboard, and the heads are starting to hang.
28-0 for the Airedales, and here comes the kickoff, and it's a good one. Espinoza back to his 10. Espinoza to the 20. Head
nice.
Of steam up to about the 27-yard line.
Caden Lamb and who's that number one? Is that Cash Ferris? Yeah, both of them in on the tackle. Cash Ferris did a good job getting around the blocker to get in there to make that tackle.
Football is at the 28. That's an 18-yard return and a first down. Airedales have some backups on the field right now. Mulligan is in there.
Taking over for Eric Johnson.
Yep. Here we're getting a little breather. Quarterback, back to pass. Got to hurry. Being chased. Gets away. Going to run it. And he is going to have himself a nice little run on first down. Close to a first down, about 10 yards.
Gain of about 11. Brings up a Pryor, Tigers.
Got an injured player.
I get a lineman shaking up. Let's hope he's okay. Yeah, the Airedales have a few backups in there, giving some starters a little bit of a breather.
Yeah, he went to the left with a fake on that and then came back to the right.
My man Zach Millsap, center, playing some defense for the Airedales. First down after a run of about 11 yards. Here is a quarterback back to pass. Whoa. It's caught. Boy, he's got some space. And that's going to be a first down inside the 40.
How did he get that off?
I don't know. He was covered
up. Was
that
Mulligan on top of him when he threw that ball? Like we've got a cramp.
Got a cramp. Yep, that's exactly what that is.
Injury time out on the field.
3:36 to play in the third quarter. It's Alma 28 and Pryor nothing. Let's take timeout.
Omega Car and Truck Accessories would like to invite you to come by and take a tour of our new retail showroom behind Brahms in Alma. Interactive working displays and a fully stocked warehouse allow you to pick out today's hottest accessories and get them installed fast. Wheels and tires, audio video, LED lighting, steps, lift kits, bed liners, custom interiors, towing, computer cut window tinting, Omega does it all. And with certified technicians, we guarantee the job will be done right. If customer service and value are important to you, choose Omega Car and Truck Accessories.
Yeah, when you get an injury like that, that's usually a warm weather injury.
Yeah.
It's not so much an injury as it is just a discomfort.
It's a huge discomfort.
It is much uncomfortable.
Kendrick Props, the injured player, is going to be okay. A little cramp.
Yeah, they'll get him some fluids. He'll be fine.
Pryor's got a first down, back-to-back plays. They're inside the Alma 40. Quarterback back to pass, gets his pass away. It's going to be incomplete.
Incomplete.
I'm going to say catch. Nope, no catch.
No catch.
Pass incomplete. Attendant number two.
Zach Millsap. I want to talk about Zach and Eric Johnson. They're best friends. They go to church.
They do.
At the Mulberry Church over there.
Yep.
And I think Zach's dad's the youth pastor.
Zach is another one of those kids that's on that Alma Youth Trap Club.
Yeah.
And he has been our top-rated shooter the last season. And took a team down to a state competition this past spring. Good kid. I like Zach a lot.
Here's a run to Espinoza, and he's got a nice run on second down and long. Gets it to about the Alma 31-yard line. Yep, these kids, good fellowship. They hang out. Good bonding together. That's our run. Of about 7 yards. So to bring up third down and about three.
Eagle. They got three wide receivers up top.
Yeah, flood that left side.
Espinoza
gonna
gets
hand
the ball.
It off to Espinoza, and Espinoza is going to be stacked up inside the 30. I don't think he has it. Let's depends on where
Espinoza
the spot is. It's kind of funny when you're on a visiting. We're in a visiting press box, so you're used to seeing the chains on the other side.
Yeah. I keep looking for the other sideline. I'm like, where are the chains?
They're right over here. So that's going to be really about no gain.
It'll be fourth and three.
Yeah, fourth down.
And Pryor's obviously going to have to go for this here if they want to get on the board at all.
2 minutes and 23 seconds to play. Really, that big play in the first half, that stop on fourth and goal, is huge in this game.
It is. Espinoza's been shut down. They've done a really good job of keeping him in check.
Fourth down and three. Quarterback rolls to his left. He needs about 3 yards. Gets his pass away.
Nice.
It's in. Almost intercepted.
Cash Ferris broke that
ready
up.
To say Cash Ferris had it, but he dropped it.
He read it. He saw it coming. See, that's just good coaching. I mean, he was in position to make that play.
Yeah.
You don't just guess on where that's going. That's a scheme they put in there into play, and they did a good job of executing it. And that's another turnover.
Yeah. Hats off to Zach Jones. Defense, another fourth down, ball goes over on downs.
I mean, I know they do statistics on fourth down conversion, but you really ought to think of those as turnovers, because if you don't get that, you're giving it away to the other team right there.
2 minutes and 1 second left to play here in this third quarter. Alma's on top 28-0. Jackson Daly at quarterback gets his quick
little
pass.
Wide receiver
in
screen
the flat
to Polecat.
The Polecat got his third catch on the year, and fourth catch on the year. Gets a run over a catch of about 6 yards.
First quarter's winding down. Got about a minute 45.
I'm going to call that a gain of 7. So I'm going to have to disagree with the PA announcer on that one, PA announcer. Second down and short for the Airedales. They lead it by 4 touchdowns. Daly in the pistol formation is going to hand it off.
Carlos.
And Carlos Gonzalez running hard to the 40-yard line.
I think he's got that.
Gonzalez with the carry for the Airedales, brought down by number 60, Gilbert Cantrell, along with number 56, Jackson.
Oh, Mayors. Just short.
Yep, didn't give it to him. Third down. Third down and about a half a foot.
Number 58, Mason McElwain.
1 minute left here in this third quarter.
Yeah, I'll give the PA guy a little bit of little love because sometimes the referee will mark it, and then he'll move.
He'll move it back. does happen a lot.
Yeah.
Third down and one. It's a handoff to Gonzalez, and Gonzalez is stacked up. No gain. In fact, he might lose a yard or two.
Yeah.
And so the Airedales, for the first time tonight, will punt this football away.
We think. Schlegel's back there. He'll punt it.
Fourth down and short. They keep the offense on the field.
They're going to let the clock run out.
They are. Little time to talk about it.
2 second differential.
Play clock.
There.
I almost said shot clock. Yeah. Wrong sport.
We'll get there soon enough.
Yep. Yeah, the play clock is a little bit ahead. Now they're going to get a. That's it.
Yeah, don't rush me out of my football season. It just started.
So, after three quarters of play, it's Alma 28 and Pryor nothing. Let's take time out.
Spartan General Contractors is a construction company equipped with highly trained and experienced individuals ready to support you with your next construction project. Residential or commercial, Spartan has the resources needed to help you achieve your final goal. One of our main objectives at Spartan is to keep your project on time and within your budget. While the thoughts of your next construction job can seem complex and overwhelming, let Spartan General Contractors help alleviate that stress and make your next project become reality.
Well, we're not quite done with our third quarter, so Alma's going to keep the win, and they're going to punt it, looks like.
Yep.
They call a timeout with 1 second left?
They did. They had 2 seconds left between that and the play clock, but I'm guessing it's because of the wind, because right now the wind is at their back.
It is. It's picked up a little bit.
And they don't want to kick into it, so see if we can drive them back a little further. Is that Landon Morris back there punting?
Let's see. The Airedale punter is Byron Standridge.
Standridge, okay.
Number 3. Byron, looks like they may be coming. They are coming. Gets his kick away. It's a beauty.
Good kick.
Going to bounce. Alma's going to get a roll out of that.
Got an Airedale roll for sure.
Great punt from Byron Standridge. He had a tough time in week one, but that's a beauty right there.
He did. He struggled in week one, but that one, that's a good punt. Good call by the coach to take that timeout, get the wind at your back.
So that'll do it after three quarters officially. It is Alma 28, Pryor nothing. Let's take timeout.
Here at the University of Arkansas Fort Smith, we do things differently.
Because here, learning doesn't just happen on screens and in books. We learn through action.
With degree plans that are on our terms, whether in class or online.
And because UAEFS is the most affordable four-year campus in Arkansas,
we can do it all without going into debt.
So when we graduate, we don't just have a diploma. We have a resume that will launch our careers.
That's a 41-yard punt. Nice punt and a good roll. Good coverage by the punt team as well. Good special teams all the way around. And the Airedales have the Tigers backed up to their 22. As we open up this fourth quarter, Kevin Taylor and David Wright back with you at Pryor, Oklahoma. And the Airedales have had a good time tonight, up 28-0.
It's always good when you put a zero on the board for the other team. Everybody enjoys the ride home a lot better.
Oh, yeah. First down run. Espinoza's got it, trying to bounce outside, and he is bottled up. He is going to go backward. Good job by the Airedale defense.
They had that well contained. He tried to bounce, but there wasn't anything there.
Michael Taylor, one of those down there, and Noah Ingold out there.
I think Mulligan had the initial blocker tied up, and the rest of them came in and cleaned up. So
Joseph Lynn getting some reps on the tackle.
Loss of one on the play.
Had Joey on my baseball team back in the day, T-ball.
That's a while ago.
He was a wild man, old Joseph. He's a good kid. Quarterback back to pass. Looking.
Pressure.
Is going to be sacked.
Down.
He is dropped. Nice play by the Airedale defense. Donald Mulligan back there. It's going to bring up third down and long. Got a flag down. That flag came late.
Yeah.
Airedales were kind of celebrating. I don't know what they were. What the flag is on.
That looked clean, unless he did something getting up. But
yeah.
But the white hat was right there on top of it, so I don't know.
That's that side judge. Yeah, we're going to call it against Alma. Wow.
Oh.
Okay.
Okay.
That side judge has been worked over by that sideline by the prior coaches.
Yeah, that could have been. That's one of those in the pile type of deals that we can't see from the angle we're at. So I can't complain about that.
No, wipe out the quarterback sack. That's a tough break there. Yeah. First down from the 36-yard line. Ward straight drop back to pass. Rushes on, gets his pass away.
Nice.
It's caught. Great tackle by
Minshew.
Caden Minshew.
Nice.
Boy, what a play from Caden.
Yeah, Caden was all over that.
No gain on the pass play.
Jackson Mitchell in there with the pressure. Starting to see 56 kind of all over the field.
Yeah, Jackson's had a nice year so far. Third down and 10. I'm sorry, second down and 10 from the 36. Ward gets his instructions, and he is going to hand it off on a jet sweep. And that's Props trying to get outside back in the game. And Props is going to be hit out of bounds. There's a flag down. Let's check the marker. Could be a block in the back. Let's see. They're
that's
talking
likely
to Rusty
on the
Bush.
Offense.
Yep. So Props, who had the cramp earlier, is back out there.
But I tell you what, Donald Mulligan, again, down there on that edge,
yeah,
he is holding his edge. And he is making them go wide, which is giving the rest of the defense time to pursue.
So a penalty on the Tigers to back them up. Replay second down. 10 minutes and 24 seconds left here in this game. Kevin Taylor and David Wright with you tonight from Pryor, Oklahoma. The Airedales led it 14-0 at halftime and put two more touchdowns on the board in that third quarter.
One running back in the backfield. You got three wide receivers to the far side. One down here on the near side.
Second down and long. They got to go about 20 yards. Quarterback straight drop. Looking. Gets his pass away. It's going to be caught out there. That's a good play.
Good route.
Pass is caught. Not a first down. Roberts about 4 yards shy to bring up third down.
Taylor is right there on coverage. It's just a good route.
Yep. Good job of the Tiger offensive line. Good protection that time. Third down and short. Right at 10 minutes left here in this game. Quarterback Ward going to fake the handoff. Back to pass. Gets his pass away. It's incomplete.
No flags.
Good coverage out there by the Airedales. Chanavong.
Another fourth down.
Fourth down and about four. See if they go for it. They're going to keep the offense on the field. So the Tigers have a fourth down and four from their 42. It's Alma on top 28-0. Thanks again to our scoreboard sponsor, Simon Dentistry. Ward, good protection, slings it outside. It's
no catch.
Incomplete.
Incomplete. Another turnover on downs.
Good coverage out there by Michael Taylor.
Michael Taylor knocked it loose out of his hands. I'm not sure he'd have caught that anyway, but Michael made sure he didn't.
Looking forward, Michael, good baseball player.
Yep.
So we got ourselves a
that'll be fun.
Addition for the baseball team.
Him and Mr. Risley.
Yeah.
When he gets off his injury, should be
good to
good
go
addition.
By springtime.
Yeah.
So Alma takes over at the 42, 9 minutes and 48 seconds. And right now, you could probably taste it. I think you can just taste this one and Airedales try to keep everybody healthy and just take this one to the house up by four touchdowns.
See if we get one more score and put this away.
Daly in the pistol formation. The running back is Towns Robinson. It's going to be a run to Izzy, and Izzy is bottled up. No gain. Second down and about 10.
He ran into one of our own guys. I think that was Eric Johnson. I think Eric got turned, and he and Izzy met face-to-face there.
Caden Minshew checked in for the Airedales. Caden had some carries last week. He may be called upon here. 9 minutes left here in this game. Minshew, 10 carries, 47 yards. His longest run was 12 yards last week. He almost popped that.
Yeah. He's kind of shifty down there, too, because he's a few inches shorter than those guys. He's hard to find.
He is hard to find. Daly back to pass, looking, gets his pass in the flat.
Open.
Caught out there at the 42, and the Airedales run it up to the 40 or 35. Samuel Schlegel, another catch on the night. That's a short gain, third down and about five from the 36. Gain of about 6 yards, third down and about four.
I'm just really impressed with how accurate Jackson has been this season. I mean, being a first-year starter, he's done a really good job of hitting his receivers, and he's clearly developed some good chemistry with Samuel.
He has indeed. Third down and four, 8 minutes left here in the game. Those two have hooked up a bunch.
They have.
17 times on the year.
Another good
block. Daly gets his pass away, just throws that one out of bounds. Being safe.
Nowhere to get with it. Good. Good play.
So the Airedales going to probably keep the offense on the field. Downs Robinson checks back in. Fourth down play for the Airedales. Our press box, we've got two windows open, and there's two. How do you explain that? It's double pane.
It's a double pane, but there's clearly a leak in both of them.
There's a fog in there.
Because there's a fog with water running down, and you can't see out of either one of them.
Fourth down play for the Airedales. Daly gets his pass. Schlegel's got it. Schlegel's going to be short. Right at the sticks. Well, let's see. It's close. He might have it. He did have it.
First down.
He needed about four. Looks like it about five.
You're sitting in the home stands. You're saying, what do we need to do?
7 minutes, 45 seconds left here in this game, and the Airedales have a first down at the Pryor 31. Just trying to run some clock here.
Izzy's back there again. Get Caden Lamb.
This is kind of when you want to do that old Frankie Vines offense. Just keep it on the ground, run that
run,
clock.
Run, run.
Here's a run nice to Towns hole. Robinson. And he's got a lot of space out to the 26-yard
nice
line.
Hole.
5 yards on that first down play.
The carry once again for the Airedales, brought down on the play by number 58 for the Tigers. That's Mason McElvain.
Well, the big key tonight, certainly the defense had some huge stops, but the offense, first down.
First down.
It's been a killer.
They've been winning on first down.
They've been winning first down.
Offense gets real easy when you win first down.
It does.
I say that standing up here, but...
Football is at the Pryor, 26. Yep. Second down and five for the Airedales. They are on top 28-0. Daly back to pass.
Fake.
Looking. Got a man
fake.
Down there. The pump to the end
What's
zone. The ball is going to be incomplete.
Pass
intended
for number 14.
Oh. He's going to kick himself when he watches that one because I think that hit him in the chest.
Third down for the Airedales.
He might have had a hand in his eye, but.
6 minutes and 36 seconds left here in the clock.
See, that's some more of that quarterback development that is really nice to see. You got a pump fake, and then you go for the throat. That was nice. Because I saw a lot of defenders stop at the pump fake. I wonder where the ball went.
Here's a run to Towns Robinson. Izzy's got a first down and more, and Towns Robinson cracks it inside the 20. Move those chains.
And see, a win on first down enables you to have a short third down if you go for it on second and don't get it. Third down is easier to pick up for sure.
6 minutes left on the clock, and Alma methodically running down the field. A short field at that, first down and 10 inside the 20. It's a run to Towns Robinson, and Izzy backs his way to about the 13.
He's just running through the A and B gaps now.
Israel Towns Robinson again with the game.
Daring them to stop him.
So the Airedales are going to be 2-1, getting ready for the conference opener with Clarksville.
And Carlos back in there.
Gonzalez checks back in. Second down for the Airedales after a gain of about 3. Daly in the pistol. Hands it off to Gonzalez, straight ahead. Carlos Gonzalez
still running
inside the
10, running
inside the 5 to about the 3.
Fresh legs,
and a first down and goal for the Airedales.
That's a good run by Carlos. Nice run.
Nice job of the coaching staff on a short week. Came well as a normal week. He came back after that first game. He had a little bit of time after that first game. And the Airedales are going to have a first down and goal from the 4, up 28-0.
Izzy's back in the
Daly
backfield.
In the pistol formation. Schlegel wide to the left side. It's going to be a run to Towns Robinson, straight ahead. Izzy to about the 1.
Oh, that down.
Second down. Well, Pryor's going to have a next game next week. They will take on Ulaga.
Did they scrimmage them earlier this season already?
Maybe.
I feel like I saw that somewhere where they scrimmaged them earlier this year.
First down or second down and goal from the 1. It's going to be a run again to Towns Robinson. He's hitting the backfield. Law dropped at the 4.
They sold out on the run on that one.
So the Airedales have a third down and goal from the 4.
Third down, Airedales.
3 minutes and 38 seconds left here in this football game. Great job by the coaching staff all across the board. Tough losses last night. The ninth grade team took one 24-10. And the seventh grade lost a tough one to Shiloh Christian 20-14.
Yeah, I got to see the end of that freshman game. There were some bright spots there at the very end.
You double dip last night.
I had double duty, yeah. Play.
Daly, back to pass. Oh, Izzy's nice. Caught it at the 1.
Touchdown.
Gets in for a touchdown.
Oh, that's Byron Standridge, isn't it? Yeah, that's Standridge.
Byron Standridge caught it. Byron Standridge threw the foggy window, and the Airedales extend that lead to 34-0.
Yeah, called the volleyball game last night and then went over to the stadium, and Coach Lockridge said, thank goodness you're here, and he left.
Byron Standridge with his first career touchdown, and the Airedales extend that lead to 34-0. PAT kick is good.
That was a nice kick. That one had a little more juice on it than the other ones did.
Cade Minchell is 14 for 14 on the year, and the Airedales up for 35-0. 3 minutes and 3 seconds left. Let's take timeout.
Accidents are never fun. Don't take your vehicle to just anyone. The professional team at Autoplex is committed to quality first and your complete satisfaction. Our ASE certified technicians will repair your vehicle to pre-accident condition efficiently and quickly with a warranty on all repairs, on-site insurance filing, and rental cars available. At Autoplex, we look forward to making your experience with us easy in our state-of-the-art facility. Autoplex Collision Repair. Quality first, always.
Well, the Airedales are going to win this football game. I see a lot of cars in the parking lot headed for home, wherever that may be. We got ourselves about a 2.5-hour bus ride back to Crawford County.
Yeah, our visitor stands filled up nicely this evening.
Mulligan's kick. It's a high
nice
kickoff.
High one.
And going to bounce.
Oh, that's,
and
that's a fair ball.
Have a first down. They let it bounce.
Wow.
That's a first down for Alma. How about the same thing as an onside kick?
That's better than an onside kick. You didn't have to get anybody hit.
Wow.
Espinosa really messed that one up. He, yeah, that's a fair ball.
Yep.
Live ball when it hits the ground like that.
He just let it drop and dropped in there for a first down.
I don't know if he thought that was going to bounce out of bounds or what, but he was still too far away for that.
Almost got it at the 30, or I'm sorry, inside the 30.
23.
The 23. So 3 minutes and 1 second left. Probably a lot of backups will be checking in for the Airedales.
I would think so.
Michael Taylor is the backup quarterback. And
the clock's running now.
Let's see if Michael Taylor is in there. He is in there at quarterback. Yeah. Now we got the clock running. Taylor is a left-hander. Going to hand it off to Caden. Or nope, that's not Caden Minshew.
Number five.
Number five for the Airedales. Takes his first carry. It's Jacob Dollard.
Oh, yeah, Jacob Dollard. I'll get these numbers sooner.
Yeah.
I got to stop remembering who wore them last year.
Yeah. Yeah, the first time I saw Cash Ferris.
Yeah.
Thinking about Brady Noyes, yeah. And Brady at the number one, Ferris. Well,
Birchfield
was
five.
Yeah.
I knew it wasn't Reagan, though. I mean.
So, nice run by Jacob Dollard on first down, second down for the Airedales. Michael Taylor in at quarterback. Going to be nothing but runs from here on out. It's going to be Dollard again.
Yep.
And not too much. Good pursuit by that defense. And we are under 2 minutes left.
Yeah, they're just lined up. They're just lined up to stop the run.
Kind of an interesting game. The Airedales spread out the touchdowns tonight. Caden Minshew's got a touchdown. Schlegel's got a touchdown. Jackson Daly's got a touchdown. Byron Standridge has a touchdown.
And is that five of them?
Daly has two.
Daly has two.
Yeah.
Didn't Izzy get one? Did you say Izzy?
Izzy, I got to go back and look at that.
Too many
down.
Scores.
Yeah, too many shots in. A minute left in the game, a handoff on third down and short. And the Airedales are not going to get the first down. That's a different ball carrier on that carry for the Airedales. That's number 33. That is Logan English.
Logan English, okay.
Another big piece on our baseball team.
Yes. Logan is a good athlete. He pretty well excels at everything he does.
He does.
Started a lot as a freshman on the baseball team last year, which is pretty impressive.
All right, the Airedales have a fourth down. They're going to keep the offense on there. We're under 40 seconds left to play in this football game. Alma's going to be 2-1.
Yeah, if Logan gets
1-1 on the road.
If Logan gets a window, they won't catch him.
He can run.
Oh, that's not the window.
No window.
No window there.
And that'll do it. Yeah. Ball goes over on downs. 22 seconds. Clock continues to run. They're going to stop it with 19 seconds. So the Airedales off next week. They'll have some time to get ready, catch those bumps and bruises. Nice job on defense tonight.
Important part about next week is focusing on Clarksville.
And that offense.
And that offense. And not focusing on the week next after that.
Right.
Watching Clarksville play last year, that was tough to watch.
Quarterback passes incomplete. 16 seconds left here in this game. Clock has stopped. So the Airedales are going to win it. Alma's going to go to 2-1. Pryor is going to drop to 1-1. They beat Locust Grove 45-10 in their first game. Quarterback back to pass, swings it across the middle. It's complete. Some space out there. First down all the way up to the 48-yard line. Let's call it the 47-yard line. This might be the last play. 7 seconds left on the clock. Now
sure.
It's a four. This will be the last play.
It
it's
going to
be quarterback's going to keep it. That'll do it. Quarterback is going to run to the 40, and he's going to be down. And that'll do it. Ball game is over. The Airedales are 2-1 after a 35-0 win against the Pryor Tigers.
Good game, gentlemen. Good game.
Want to thank Airwaves Media and all the help tonight. And David Wright as well, as the Airedales get the win tonight. They win it 35-0. and Alma improves to 2-1 on the year. We will see you in 2 weeks in Clarksville. So long, everybody.
In 1886, aluminum was developed. The first Coca-Cola was sold. The Statue of Liberty was dedicated. And Citizens Bank and Trust in Crawford County opened for business. We say, they don't make things like they used to. And maybe that's true. But for over 130 years, Citizens has served the residents of Crawford County with the best financial products and services available. And like aluminum, Coca-Cola, and the Statue of Liberty, we plan on being around for a while. Citizens Bank and Trust. That's my bank for all of Crawford County.